नमस्कार एंड हेलो, वेलकम टू योर फेवरेट श्रीदेवी क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल वेयर वी इनकल्केट इंटरेस्ट एंड कॉन्फिडेंस इन इंजीनियरिंग एप्लीकेशंस बाय क्लैरिटी ऑफ कंसेप्ट एंड राइट अंडरस्टैंडिंग। टुडे इन आवर प्लेलिस्ट बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग वील स्टडी हिस्ट्री ऑफ इनोवेशन इन लाइटिंग इंडस्ट्री एंड अंडरस्टैंड हाउ इलेक्ट्रिक लाइट हैज चेंज्ड फ्रॉम इनकंडेंस लैम्प टू मॉडर्न LED लाइट्स। लेट्स स्टार्ट। It was known to ancient people that fire not only provide heat and warmth, can also provide visible sensation in dark night conditions. And ancient Egyptian developed first clean, safe, controlled and cool light source as candles. And wax candles are used initially to produce light effects and visible sensations. Soon William Murdoch produced oil and gas lamp lanterns where flames in oil or gas produce lighting sensations, but the first electrical lamp was developed after a long exercise by Thomas Alva Edison in the year 1879 as incandescent lamp. Initially, carbon filament was used. Later on, tungsten filament were also used. For the quest of higher energy efficient lighting, arc discharge lamps were developed and T.G. Inman have developed fluorescent tube light in year 1934. And its compact version, compact fluorescent lamp, was developed in the year 1976 by Edward Hemmer. And recently, the most energy efficient and future light source, light emitting diodes, were discovered in the year 2006. Let's understand this entire history in detail, but let's first start with what is visible light. This large spectra at which at one end there is cosmic and gamma rays and to other there is micro, meter wave or radio wave is called electromagnetic radiation. Now all radiations, whether they are X-ray, ultraviolet, visible or infrared, all have same traveling velocity in the same medium, and travel velocity V is given as product of length of one wave, that is called wavelength, and number of wave produced per second, that is called frequency. Cosmic gamma got smaller wavelength and higher frequency, and corresponding to frequency nu, H nu is energy of electromagnetic radiation. So gamma and cosmic rays are of higher energy radiations. Typically X-ray got wavelength of 1 angstrom or 10 to the power minus 10 meter or frequency of the order of 10 to the power 18 hertz. Now visible light, which help us in visual sensation, got a small part of this large electromagnetic radiation. To one end of visible we have red color and to other side of it we have infrared spectrum of electromagnetic radiation, and the other end of visible light ends with violet color and to next of it is ultraviolet radiation. In infrared radiation and ultraviolet radiation we won't have any visible sensation, and visible light starting from red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo and violet is a small part of this entire electromagnetic radiation. Red color of visible light, which got approximately 7000 angstrom wavelength and 4 into 10 to the power 14 hertz frequency, and in terms of energy, red color radiations got 1.5 eV energy. So red color is smallest energy and smallest frequency component of visible light, but got maximum wavelength, whereas in the mid, yellow green got approximately 5500 angstrom wavelength, and in 10 to the power 14 hertz order its magnitude is 6 times 10 to the power 14 and energy value is 2.5 eV. And for blue and violet, wavelength is 4000 angstrom, frequency is highest 8 into 10 to the power 14 hertz, and energy value is 3.5 eV. So these figures are quite easy to remember in terms of frequency, 4, 6 and 8 into 10 to the power 14 respectively for red, yellow, green and blue. And similarly, energy value can be remembered as middle visible light yellow green got 2.5 eV energy, and one end got 1.5 eV energy at red side, and other blue end got 3.5 eV energy. For the same amount of radiation of different color, visible sensitivity of human eye is different. We are more sensitive to yellow green light, and yellow green light produce more visual sensations, and extreme colors red and blue got smaller visible sensations. That's why night lamps are used with red or blue color, whereas the fastest game tennis is played with yellow green tennis ball on yellow green grass ground. In the beginning of 18th century in year 1801, Volta developed first chemical voltaic cell with zinc and copper as two electrode and dilute sulfuric acid as an electrolytic solution. And Humphry Davy used that same voltaic cell to invent first electric light. He connected two terminals of voltaic cell across two carbon pieces with a small gap, and due to electric voltage and electric discharge, these carbon particle get heated up and a glow is produced here, and that become first electric light source. The improved version of such lamps were known as carbon arc lamp, but light output of these carbon lamps are very small, irregular and uncontrolled. So people hadn't used carbon arc lamps. We do use carbon arc to produce heat in iron metallurgical operations, and in cinematography, carbon arc lamps were used to produce projection of celluloid film on screens. To produce a practical convenient light lamp, Thomas Alva Edison has made thousands of experiments, and finally he developed first practical incandescent lamp in the year 1879 using a carbon filament or a strip coil. Soon Edison and his team developed a bamboo design carbon filament which have relatively long service life, but these carbon filament have a problem of carbon evaporation and deposition of carbon in inner envelope of glass that reduce its light output, and continuous evaporation of filament carbon finally results in fusing of filament, so such lamps won't have a long service life. Edison, during his experimental work, found that tungsten is an ideal choice for filament incandescent lamp. But in his days, the machinery and process to produce fine filament of tungsten was not available. But in beginning of 19th century, American General Electric Company GEC has developed tungsten filament incandescent lamp, which served our society for more than 100 years. And recently, in last 10 and 20 years, it was replaced by compact fluorescent lamps and now by LED lamps. Tungsten got highest melting point, but hot tungsten filament in atmospheric oxygen get readily oxidized and damaged. So to eliminate tungsten oxidation, initially vacuum environment is used in glass bulb in filament lamps, but in vacuum conditions evaporation of tungsten will increase, and that will not only reduce life of tungsten filament lamp but also produce tungsten deposition and reduce its light output. So in further development, inert gas surroundings were used around tungsten filament that has reduced evaporation of tungsten filament and increased its operating temperature. And when we increase operating temperature of filament, the total radiations, which are mostly infrared, will have larger share of visible lights, and present tungsten lamp of 60 watt or 100 watt power rating operates at around 2500 Kelvin and produce 10-12% visible radiation in its total emission of electromagnetic radiation. Invention of quartz glass, which can sustain higher operating temperature, have resulted in the development of halogen light bulbs in the year 1950s. In metal halide tungsten halone lamps, tungsten filament is heated in halone gas environment, which may be either fluorine, bromine or iodine. Now hot filament have evaporation of tungsten, and that tungsten react with halone gases and produce metal halide, and metal halide when cooled down again deposit on filament and release its tungsten back to the filament. So this property of metal halide lamp has increased life of tungsten filament by reducing evaporation of tungsten from filament and also increased the operating temperature of filament. So that has increased lumen efficiency of these halogen lamp 1.5 times of ordinary tungsten filament lamps. Both tungsten filament incandescent lamp and halogen lamp got simpler and economic construction, and they are quite easy to operate, but both have limited lifespan. Tungsten filament lamp can work for around 1000 working hours, whereas metal halogen lamp got working life of 2000 hours only, and both produce radiations which mostly of infrared nature, and visible part is only 10-12% in tungsten filament lamps and 15-20% in metal halogen lamps. Both are hot and less efficient light source. So our quest for cool and energy efficient light has initiated studies and research on arc discharge lamps. In the mid of 19th century, two German scientists, Heinrich Gessler and Julius Pflücker, discovered first fluorescent tube, a type of gas discharge lamp, and that discovery has initiated a parallel research and development and invention of energy efficient arc discharge lamp, and have it created a typical blue characteristic light by passing electric current through mercury vapor discharge lamp. And in modern high pressure mercury vapor lamp, we have a quartz arc tube which include mercury with small traces of argon. The tube has two main electrodes of tungsten which are coated with strontium oxide that reduce work function of tungsten material and increase electron emission from these electrodes when they are heated. Close to one main electrode, we have a starting electrode with a series current limiting resistance, and when AC supply is applied across main and starting electrode, initially arc in argon, which is a monoatomic gas, initiated, and that arc produce heat to vaporize mercury, and electron emission when strike mercury gas atoms, they ionize that. So soon we have mercury ions in this environment and they take over discharge from argon, and current starts flowing between two main electrodes through mercury ions and electrons. During arc discharge in mercury gas, energetic electrons strike mercury atoms and excite orbital electron of mercury to higher energy states, and those higher energy electrons of mercury atom when transit to lower energy state, they emit characteristic visible blue and ultraviolet lights, and this phosphor coating of yttrium vanadate on this outer bulb can absorb ultraviolet radiation and re-emit visible light. So this high pressure mercury vapor lamp can produce visible light output when arc discharge take place in mercury gas. We can explain circuit and working of mercury vapor lamp. During arc discharge between two main electrodes, the current between main and starting electrode get reduced by presence of this high series resistance, and in this arc discharge conditions, electron strike mercury atom, excite electron, and excited electron when transit back to lower energy state emit visible and ultraviolet radiations, and most of the ultraviolet radiation is converted again in visible light by phosphor coating used in these lamps. Now arc discharge got a negative resistance characteristic, so it was a real problem to control current in such arc discharge conditions. So inductive chokes are used to control current in these arc discharge lamps. Now inclusion of these chokes has produced problem of power factor, and current in these alternating current circuits lacks applied voltage by a considerable angle. So to improve power factor, shunt capacitors are used across supply voltage in these lamps. Ordinary tungsten filament incandescent lamp has lumen efficiency of 10 to 15 lumen per watt, whereas halogen lamps are relatively more efficient and have lumen efficiency 15 to 20 lumen per watt. But quest for higher energy efficient light source results in development of fluorescent lamps, and these fluorescent lamps belongs to a family of gas discharge lamp which generate light radiation when during electric discharge in gases, electrons of gas atom get excited, and those excited electron when transit to lower energy state emit characteristic visible or ultraviolet radiation. Discharge in mercury at ordinary pressure can emit only ultraviolet radiations, and only at high pressure conditions mercury vapor lamp can emit a significant part of characteristic blue light along with majority of ultraviolet radiation, and we have used phosphor material to convert those ultraviolet into visible. But sodium vapor lamp and neon vapor lamp can emit characteristic visible lights. In sodium vapor lamp, step up transformer of high leakage reactance produce starting high voltage between these two metal electrodes. Initially, electric discharge takes place in neon ions as monoatomic neon gas easily get ionized and start conduction of discharge current. Now, electrons strike two sodium atoms, ionize sodium, and in 5 to 8 minutes, electric discharge will shift from neon to sodium and emission will change from characteristic pink color to characteristic yellow color when discharge in sodium takes place. In sodium, we have characteristic emission of around 5600 angstrom, which is typical yellow light having higher visible sensitivity. So these sodium vapor lamp not only emit more lumen radiations per watt around 60 to 70, those yellow radiation got higher visible sensitivity. So are very useful for outdoor lighting in large areas and long and wide roads. But since they won't have any color rendering properties, so they are not convenient for indoor application, and even sodium lamps are not used on road crossings. Here in sodium vapor lamp, as R got negative resistance characteristic, to limit arc current, we use a high leakage reactance transformer, which when current increases, reduce voltage across electrodes to limit current. In modern sodium vapor lamp, in place of earlier electromagnetic transformer, we use an electronic igniter circuits, which manage initial high voltage across electrodes to initiate electric arc and later on reduce voltage to limit current in the circuit. All gas discharge lamps or fluorescent lamps are quite efficient, but neither sodium vapor lamp or high pressure mercury vapor lamp is convenient in use for indoor applications. So for quest of higher efficiency for indoor lighting applications, American lighting companies in year 1950s developed phosphor coating on low pressure mercury discharge tube and developed modern tube light. In domestic tube lights, we have two sizes. One is 600 mm long tube and another one is 1200 mm long tube, respectively of 20 and 40 watt power consumption. Now these tubes got two filament electrodes at two sides made of nickel alloy with strontium oxide coating. When current passes through these filaments or electrons strike these filaments, these hot filaments emit electrons and also heat inner tube environment. If we study the circuit of domestic tube, then supply voltage have a chalk ballast coil, two electrodes and a starter in a series circuit. Initially, when AC voltage is applied across this circuit, it come across open contact of starter, where in a small gap monoatomic neon gas is provided and a discharge take place in that neon gas that produce heat, and by heat these two bimetallic strip of starter will bend and close the starter contact, and current will flow in series circuit and electrons are emitted and heat is produced to vaporize and ionize mercury in this fluorescent tube inner volume, and mercury get vaporized and ionized in this tube volume. Soon heat of arc get dissipated, cold bimetallic strip once again get separated, so all of sudden current passing through ballast is interrupted, and that sudden change in inductance current will produce high voltage which try to circulate current in the circuit, and that high voltage come across these two electrode as well as across starter. If this medium is already ionized, then current will start flowing through the tube from one electrode to another electrode, and now starter is of no use. So here this chalk ballast has act as a high voltage source to initiate electric arc within tube. Now during arc discharge, electrons in mercury atom get excited by strike of energetic electrons, and those excited electron when transit to lower energy state will emit characteristic ultraviolet radiations, and we have produced suitable phosphor material of zinc sulfide, some tungstate and borate of materials which emit a combination of all characteristic visible light, and we got a amazing combination of red, orange, yellow, green, blue and violet light, such that combination become just like daylight. Now R got negative resistance characteristic, so to limit current, this chalk coil will act. These tube lights are very energy efficient light source and they can emit 60 lumen per watt. That means a 40 watt tube light can emit 2400 lumen when new. In this tube light operation, significant amount of power is consumed by resistance of chalk coil, and this power consumption is 10 to 15 watt. For energy efficient operation of such light source, we have developed electronic ballast without starter. Now main supply is given to input terminal of electric ballast, and 4 wires, 2 for each terminal's electrode, are connected with tube light, and this electronic circuit initially circulate current through side electrode filament that heated and emit electron and heat in this space to vaporize and ionize mercury here, and at the same time a high electric potential difference is created between these two electrode to initiate electric discharge between electrodes. Since this electronic circuit works on high frequency, alternating mains AC supply of 50 Hz is converted into DC first and then again converted into a high frequency alternating current. So to limit current in this negative resistance arc discharge conditions, we need a very small amount of inductance in this electronic ballast. So small inductance coil have proportionally small resistance and small power losses. So just by power loss of around 2 watt, we can control current flow in this 40 watt tube lights using electronic ballast. So overall efficiency of this domestic tube light has increased. Domestic tube light works on electric discharge in mercury at low pressure and emit good quality cool light with all color rendering properties with very high efficiencies of 60 lumen per watt. But it got a long strip fixture, a bulky ballast and relatively higher cost. Now oil crisis of 1973 has produced a hike in energy prices, and that demanded energy efficient fluorescent lamps to be developed for small wattage capacities for residential applications. So two American companies, Sylvania and General Electric, has miniaturized the ballast, and they designed ballast in such a manner that ballast get fitted with lamp assembly in a single unit. They also folded or spiraled this arc discharge tube to make its size compact. Initially, cost of these compact fluorescent lamps is quite high and they are less reliable. Their light output is also not comparable to conventional fluorescent tube lights. But recently, Chinese manufacturing industries has made tremendous progress and adopted economic large-scale production processes and reduced the prices of these compact fluorescent lamps, and that initiated the promotion of these lamps in every household. The initial CFL were quite big and bulky, costly, unreliable, little inefficient. But modern CFLs become small in size, less in weight, consistent in performance, and economic in initial price and operations. Now CFLs got a lifetime of around 5,000 to 10,000 working hours, a very good lumen efficiency around 50 lumen per watt, and reasonable price. And most significant part is that its fixture can be adapted in ordinary bulb holder of incandescent lamp. So these CFL has replaced incandescent lamps from all domestic applications nowadays. But most significant revolution or innovation in lighting industry is development of solid state light emitting diode lamps that produce light when current passes through forward bias diodes. We know that in PN junction diode, when forward biasing is done, the in-between depletion zone is suppressed and diffusion of both side majority will take place, and as electron of N side and hole of P side diffuse across depletion zone and goes to the other side, the majority of other side will make recombination there, and in the recombination process a free electron of high energy state get a position in vacant hole of lower energy state, and this transition produce energy equivalent to forbidden gap. And if we use semiconductor base material of 3-5 combination such as gallium arsenide phosphide, then we can generate characteristic red light of 1.7 EV amount. And in 1962 GEC invented first visible LED light. If we use aluminium indium gallium phosphide, then with forbidden gap of 2.1 EV, it can emit characteristic yellow light. Similarly, gallium arsenide phosphide operating at higher voltages can emit orange light. Gallium phosphide can emit green light. And recently we found that gallium nitride with forbidden gap of 5 EV can emit characteristic blue light. In a LED, a PN junction of 3-5 base material is forward biased by two metal contact, and positive anode contact is made smaller and negative cathode contact is made to entire N side with internally at typical potting, which reflect photons to active zone, and most of the active zone is kept open and transparent during forward biasing. Majority of N side electrons and majority of P side hole diffuse across junction, and a recombination take place at junction position, and that emit characteristic light as per forbidden gap of base material. When 3-5 combination base material is used, we can get characteristic red and orange light from gallium arsenide phosphide, or yellow, green or blue light from other base materials. So base material gallium arsenide phosphide gives characteristic red light, gallium phosphide gives green light, and gallium nitride produce blue lights. And these tiny base LED, if combined together, then they can produce color light of any color by suitable combination of forward bias current in these three base LEDs. And this principle is used in modern LED TV screens and our computer monitor, or even in mobile phone screens. Now the right combination of three base color could also produce white daylight for our day-to-day visual operations, and such first commercial white LED was developed by three base LED in a single package, and red, green and blue is mixed in a certain proportion and produced characteristic day type white light. In 1994, Suji Nukamara has invented characteristic ultra bright blue LED using gallium nitride. Modern white LEDs are based on this very invention, and we used a phosphor coating of WAG yttrium aluminium garnet over this gallium nitride subtract PN junction. When this gallium nitride base subtract diode is forward biased with a voltage of around 5 volt as per energy of forbidden gap, we got characteristic blue radiations from gallium nitride LED, and those blue radiations are absorbed by WAG phosphor, and that re-emitted yellow radiations in secondary emissions, and the combination of blue and yellow become an incredible great white light as produced by sun or incandescent lamp. And these modern white LED light are very economic, highly efficient and superb in functionality, and so are becoming the future source of electric lighting. Modern LEDs are quite small in size. They are more efficient than any other light source, and they have specific direction emission, so that reduce need for reflector or diffusers. LED emit light without any heat emission, so they are very cool and pleasant light source. They light up instantly, won't have a delay as in discharge lamps, and they have reasonably long lifetime of service, around 25,000 hours. We can also easily adjust intensity and produce desired color rendering properties from these lights, so they also produce aesthetic and decorative effects through lightings, and most significant, they are not more expensive than any other light, so are replacing all other type of lighting in all application, and soon we will find that everywhere LED lights will be used in future, and they become future source of light for our mankind. And presently LED light got a lumen efficiency of around 7200 lumen per watt, but the future development in LED technology will enhance their efficiencies far beyond that, and we will get more energy efficient and more functional light through LEDs. So we learned that this incandescent tungsten filament lamp has served mankind for more than 100 years due to its simple construction and least initial cost, but they are not energy efficient, as 16-100 watt incandescent lamp have a lumen efficiency of only 12 to 15 lumen per watt. An improvement in these incandescent lamp, as metal halide halogen lamps have a little more lumen efficiency of 20 lumen per watt. But for higher efficiency, we have used gas discharge lamp and high pressure mercury vapor lamp and sodium vapor lamp having efficiency 60 or 70 lumen per watt were used in outdoor applications, and for indoor applications we have used fluorescent tube light or compact fluorescent lamps of comparable lumen efficiency. But recently LED has replaced all these other lamps due to their higher lumen efficiency, 70 to 200 lumen per watt, and better functionality.